Today, I'm going to address the relationship between the COVID-19 pandemic and sleep. I did not want to talk about this. I understand its importance, but I personally wanted to stay away from it. I'm not a medical professional, and addressing COVID-19, even as an information gatherer, seemed like a poor choice. But at the same time, valuable key research has just come out that should be addressed. As I've said many times before, I'm not a medical professional, and this time should be no different. The situation may be a bit more sensitive, but the information is still vitally important. So today, I'm addressing how the COVID-19 pandemic has affected our sleep. Hey everyone, my name is Matthew, and welcome to Calm Insomniac, where we're a community of people trying to get a better night's sleep. If you enjoy learning about sleep health, sleep tips, and relaxing classical music, then please subscribe with notifications on, and if you enjoy this video, be sure to give it a like as it greatly helps out the channel. The COVID-19 pandemic saw economic and business shutdowns on a global scale. Many countries closed business and travel, non-essential and non-healthcare workers were sent home practically overnight, school years ended abruptly, and college campuses were vacated. Even as we begin slowly returning to normalcy, a huge portion of the workforce remain working at home. And even if you aren't working at home, we find ourselves staying at home much longer than we are typically used to. This extended amount of time spent at home is the basis for the two recent research studies that addressed how COVID-19 is affecting our sleep, and they address a specific concept known as social jet lag. Our sleep cycle is often in conflict between our external social time and our internal biological time. Ideally, these two processes should be in sync with each other, but our modern world doesn't allow for this very easily. External social time is our day-to-day activities, and this includes both work and leisure activities. And internal biological time is our circadian rhythm. So let's say your internal biological clock is set to go to bed each night at 11 p.m. and wake up each morning at 7 a.m. But one day you have an early work meeting and you have to wake up before 7 a.m. And another day you have an after-work event in the evening which prevents you from going to bed till after 11 p.m. And on the weekends you stay up later and also sleep in later. The external events that keep you from maintaining your internal biological clock and the ensuing fatigue is known as social jet lag. Simply put, social jet lag is the difference in sleep timing and duration between work and free days. So how has COVID-19 affected social jet lag? Well, with most people staying home and most leisure activities not happening, social jet lag has diminished. People aren't going to concerts or parties, sporting events, or any other evening activity that can prevent them from maintaining their sleep schedule. On the other hand, people working from home are able to accomplish more while at home. This allows for increased flexibility of a social schedule. But with most social activities being restricted to being at home, this has allowed our sleep cycles to become better balanced. This means we are maintaining a better sleep schedule. We tend to be going to bed at the same time each night, including on the weekends, and we tend to be sleeping for the same amount of time each night, also including on the weekends. Even better, one of the recent studies found that people tend to sleep longer by about 15 more minutes per sleep a night. And the second study found that 92% of participants slept the minimum recommended hours of sleep a night, which is an increase from 84% prior to the pandemic. But while this data is promising, we need to consider that the data collected from the participants was self-reported by the participants. This means it wasn't scientifically collected, and the data self-reported was based on the participants' perceptions. Now, as exciting as the data I just mentioned is, it's not the complete picture. even though we're sleeping longer and more consistently, participants self-reported a decrease in their sleep quality. Again, this is based on their own perceptions, but it's highly plausible. This pandemic has brought with it all kinds of worry and uncertainty. The unknowns of the virus are cause for frequent concern, and the disruptions to our lives are unsettling at best. All of these factors cause an increase, if not a severe increase, in stress. And as I've mentioned several times on this channel before, stress is a huge factor that affects our ability to get quality sleep. Stress can prevent us from achieving deep sleep or staying in deep sleep long enough. We may wake up many more times throughout the night than normal. It may prevent us from falling asleep, or it may cause us to wake up earlier than expected. The participants attribute their decrease in sleep quality to an increase in self-perceived burden. This means they feel a physical and mental toll regarding the pandemic. This could be surrounding the unknowns of the virus, but could also be about maintaining proper health during this time. Additionally, we may feel an increased sense of burden regarding caring and providing for our family more so than we would during normal circumstances. So while it seems puzzling that we're both sleeping more and experiencing reduced sleep quality, we have to remember just how unprecedented this time is, to use a highly overused term. The final thing I want to address is how COVID-19 affects sleep in women. Some research has suggested that the pandemic has affected sleep in women more than men. While there is minimal scientific evidence at this point, this too is highly plausible. Women tend to be at a greater risk for sleep-related issues. This includes trouble falling asleep, trouble staying asleep, and are at a greater risk for insomnia. Combine these predispositions with the added stress of the pandemic, and this is a really bad combination. On top of that, women tend to face family burdens more than men. This means they feel responsibility, whether by choice or societal pressure, to care for the family, which includes meal preparation, childcare, and other family care responsibilities. Now, please don't misunderstand me. I'm not saying that men don't feel these pressures and responsibilities too. But preliminary research suggests that women feel these pressures and responsibilities more so than men. So with all the added stress of the pandemic and caring for our families in our stay-at-home world, women may disproportionately suffer from poor sleep. So that's an executive summary of the key research that explains how the COVID-19 pandemic has affected our sleep. Remember that this craziness will end and we will return to normalcy, but it's important we understand how the pandemic is affecting our sleep right now. Remember that our sleep health is vitally important to our overall health, so anything we can do to keep our sleep cycles in balance is incredibly important. And I don't plan on discussing anything else COVID-19 related unless I'm just flooded with comments and requests for more discussions on this topic. Like I said in the beginning, I really didn't want to discuss this, but I do think this is important information to share. Let me know in the comments below, how has the pandemic affected your sleep, for better or worse, and what have you done to combat any negative side effects? Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to like, subscribe, follow me on Facebook and Pinterest, check out my website, and join my email list. All of those links are down below. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about sleep health, then I suggest you check out this playlist right over here. And if you missed my last video where I explain why we feel tired in the morning, then definitely check out this video down over here. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.